Debates on immigration are usually formulated according to the dichotomy between pro-immigration and anti-immigration. It's a rhetorical trap. If you answer that you are pro-immigration, you are not expected to object to anything about it. If you want to object anything, something, so you are called anti-immigration, a notion quickly linked to hostility against individual immigrants. As a consequence, you are not allowed to freely express your critical view, but you are made subject of further name-calling, racist, and so on. This rhetorical trap should be refused. The matter is not being pro or anti-immigration. There are just two extreme positions, one xenophobic, one xenophiliac. Immigration is not one-sided, but is multifaceted. We could judge it only on a case-by-case basis, considering if newcomers are in thousands or millions from akin or exotic cultures, scientists or low-skilled, and if the host country is rich or poor, and many other variables. Therefore, my point is that the current immigration towards Europe is, considering its origin and size, our social and economic situation, a mainly negative phenomenon. First of all, considering the size, it is unprecedented in all time European history. The latest genetic researches lean towards the idea that most of current Europeans trace a line of descent to European Stone Age hunters. The barbarians who 1,500 years ago destroyed the Roman Empire and projected our continent in the Middle Age were just in the amount of 5% the population of the invaded lands. And they're coming diluted over a century. Today we are witnessing the arrival of many more people in far less time. Let's see some examples. According to Professor David Coleman of Oxford University, non-British ethnic groups, 13% of population in 2006, will be 43% in 2056, and absolute majority by 2065. According to demographer Michel Tribalat, first or second generation immigrants in France are already more than 20% of total population. And what about Italy? According to the Italian Official Statistical Institute, foreign resident population is of about 5 million people, 270% up compared to 2002. It has grown from 2.38% in 2002 to 8.29% of total population in 2016. By 2065, another 14.4 million people will immigrate in Italy. They will give birth by the same date to 2.5 million children. These are official estimations. Considering the age structure of the current foreign resident population and applying the age-specific fertility rates, by 2065, the current foreign resident population should have given birth to about 2 million children. In reality, fertility rate for foreign women is higher than for Italian women, but we want a conservative estimation. Assuming that of the original 5 million foreign resident population, the half will be still alive by 2065, this population will amount to about 4.5 million people, first or second generation immigrants. Also, there is about 1 million of citizens naturalized in the last quarter of century. Applying the natural growth rate, this population will be of 880,000 in 2065. We could so estimate by 2065 a foreign descendant population of about 22 million, in front of a total population officially estimated at 53.7 million. This is more than the 40% of total population. Until the 80s of the last century, the percentage of foreigners in Italy was negligible. Only at the 2001 census, that percentage exceeded 1%. By the end of current century, the Italian ethnics will probably be a minority in Italy. Now, with such huge numbers, let genetics alone, but also simply cultural integration is unfeasible. In fact, multiculturalism is the official model for the European elite. What does multiculturalism mean? That European nations will be no more Europeans nor nations, but just territorial administrations containing multiple communities of different cultures of the same status. In such a multicultural society, native Europeans will have to negotiate with other communities also their basic values and standards. In other words, a Lebanese scenario with even more cultural variety. As Christopher Colwell put it, multiculturalism forced natives to give up liberties they used to consider rights. According to Professor Paul Collier, multiculturalism undermines the social capital of European countries, democratic institutions, rule of law, and an inclination towards cooperation and condivision. A bit of diversity is good, but too much diversity undermines that very successful social model which immigrants pursue coming to our countries. They are, Collier argues, attracted precisely by the fruits brought by the idea of nation that has given rights to citizens, all of them, even the poor ones, the same idea of nation that native advocates of mass immigration want to see destroyed. According to Régis Debray, borders safeguard the weak. In a borderless world, the strong take advantage of free flows, but the weak just suffer them. It's true that immigration provides for cheap labor, but this comes at expense of corresponding native workers' wages. Moreover, and more important, it is widely known that lowering the labor cost discourages technological investments and productive process modernization. Concluding, I would assert that current mass immigration towards Europe is culturally, economically, and socially harmful for our nations. Italy should stop to be the soft underbelly of Europe, an open door for whoever wants to come in our continent, and embrace the policies promoted by our friends of Visegrad countries. We all have understanding and sympathy towards migrants, but we need to safeguard our own interests first. And this is finally in the best interest of immigrants too. Because coming in smaller numbers and in an orderly way, they will keep finding across the sea the wealthy and safe land of Europe and not another underdeveloped and chaotic country just like ones they are escaping from. Thank you.